Well, I've gotten the go-ahead to start talking, so I'm going to talk over your moving. I want to welcome you guys tonight to Straddling the Line. My name is Annie Hatch, and I'm from the Wyoming Arts Council. I'm really pleased to be here representing the Cowboy State. The Wyoming Arts Council is one of the many state arts councils that has representatives here, and we're so proud of our state's musicians and poets. And I'm pleased as punch to be here representing my state arts council. And I want to remind you that every state has an arts council. And so if your state arts council is not supporting the music and poetry of the cowboy community in your state, please have the local poets and musicians contact their arts council and make use of that support. What's happening in your own communities at home is really, really important, and all of that comes back and helps us with the national gathering here in Elko. So keep the fires burning on the home front so we could put together a great show for you every year in Elko. So we're celebrating the 30th anniversary. Is anyone in the audience? Was anyone here the first year? We have a hand. We've got two, three. All right, they were all about 6 years old when they were here 30 years ago. Glad to see you back. How many's here for the first time? A fair number. All right, you won't be raising your hands next year because this is your second year. Coming back next year for sure. This show, Straddling the Line, I'm really excited about. I'm so pleased and honored to be hosting this session. This is a great way to start off the 30th because we've got three really young, fresh performers, and they straddle the line between the generations, between what performances were like 30 years ago on this stage and what they are like today and what they'll be becoming in the future. They're straddling the line between their rural roots and being professional musicians and traveling the world. They're straddling the lines between having very strong ties to the land, yet being very aware of what's going on in cyberspace. They're straddling the line between the old and the new, their inspirations and where they get their musical values from and how they're putting that into play now. So this is going to be a really exciting and interesting performances from all the three that we have coming up. We've got great sponsors that are helping with this event. I really appreciate the local sponsorships from local corporations like Goldcore, Marigold Mine, Terra Tech, and the Nevada Cattlemen's Association. All those funders help make this happen every year, and they help keep the Western Folklife Center going. So first up, we've got Jessie Veeder. This is her first time here, and this is her first show in Elko. So we really want to make sure that it's a pleasant one, and we're really excited to see what she has for us. She was raised, she says, in Nowhere, North Dakota. She's going to tell us a lot more about that. One of the things that she tries to do through her lyrics and her music is give people the real impression of what it's like to live in a rural community in the United States, and to bring that to a broader and more general audience. And she succeeds at that, and I know that she's going to melt your hearts and become the darling of this year's program. And welcome to the stage, please, Jessie Veeder from North Dakota.
This is a lot of pressure. This is my first show, my first time. I'm opening this wonderful event, the Straddling the Line. You guys, wait until you hear what's coming up. I'm so excited to be here. You're just gonna love it. My name is Jessie Veeder, and I grew up on a ranch in western North Dakota. I brought with me my accent. Sounds a little Canadian, maybe. I grew up singing and writing music about what it was like to roam the hills and the coulees of the ranch where I was raised. And I grew up knowing that I wanted to sing, but more than anything, I wanted to be back there and live there forever. And 3 years ago, that's what my husband and I did. We moved back to our family's ranch, our fourth generation. Thank you. So it's a dream come true to be able to sing from there and write songs about my love for the Badlands and riding horse beside my dad and my husband chasing those Angus cows. This is a song I wrote called Nothing's Forever.
Sometimes I don't know the difference between summer and winter and the season of spring. Sometimes I don't know how happy to be, because nothing's forever, baby. Summer brings thistle and winter brings snow. Of all of the seasons, it's the last one to go. It stays till the sun has a reason to show. Because nothing's forever, baby. If you hold tight the water, it'll slip through your hands. The same goes for wild birds and hourglass sands. You can chase down the light of the last setting sun, but not catch it, no matter how fast you run. Of all of the wild things no one can tame, one thing remains, one thing still remains. I climb to the hilltop and open my hands, but nothing stares back but a dry piece of land. Sometimes I am scared I won't know who I am. Nothing's forever, baby. I call to the river, I tell her my name. She cuts through the valley, rode in the banks. She used to know me in a different way. See, nothing's forever. It'll slip through your hands. The same goes for wild birds and hourglass sands. You can chase down the light of the last setting sun, but you will not catch it, no matter how fast you run. Of all of the wild things no one can tame, one thing remains, one thing still remains. I knew you when you were a child. Didn't have a burdens like your daddy did. You rode on broke horses and man, how you live. Like nothing's forever, baby. Now I see you have the worries and lines around your eyes from a world made just smaller with all its goodbyes. The world just keeps spinning from day into night, singing nothing's forever, baby. If you hold tight the water, it'll slip through your hands. The same goes for wild birds and hourglass sands. You can chase down the light of the last setting sun, but you'll not catch it, no matter how fast you run. Of all the wild things no one can tame, one thing remains, one thing still remains. My love is forever, baby. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much. thank you, thank you. Well, I grew up listening to folk music. You know, I grew up 30 miles from town. My dad is a folk musician, and he used to play for me Emmylou Harris and John Prine and Lyle Lovett and all of these, Ian Tyson, all of these guys that had songs that kind of painted a picture of the people that I fell in love with and came to know. And back in those days, I'm not that old, but me and the Cowboy Poetry Gathering are the same age. Yeah, so if I have to be 30, at least something else cool is 30 too. but I used to listen to these songs my dad was singing, and it was back before we had YouTube, or I had like 3 radio stations I could maybe listen to in my room, so we were hungry for anything and any influence, because I was playing guitar and writing poems in my room about wildflowers and the creek behind my house. But my favorite stories were always about the ones about the people of this landscape. And what's happening right now in Western North Dakota is that there's a lot more people coming into the landscape, right? You heard about that little Bakken boom? Maybe some of you work up there, maybe some of your kids go there and come back home to Idaho or Texas after the work is done. People always ask me about that. I'm a writer too. I write a column and I write a blog. And I always am telling the story of my home state, because not a lot of people knew about North Dakota before they found oil again or found another way to get it out of the ground. And I didn't want to talk about the long lines at the post office anymore. I didn't want to talk about the traffic anymore. I wanted to talk about the people, because there's so many people out there and they all have a story. So I sat down one night when we were living in my grandma's old house and my husband was cooking soup, and I thought about all the people I met in Boomtown, Watford City. Population when I graduated, it was 1,200. Population now, they don't know, but maybe 15,000. And to see your town change like that and see the people come in is really quite the thing. So I wrote this song about it. This is called Boomtown. Donnie's got a truck and he's always here on time. Big buttes and gravel roads, he keeps it between two lines. $30 an hour and the pay is good, but no time's better spent than the way a daddy should. Still he hangs around. Shelly don't stop moving till the sun goes down. What she once was, she's not. What she's lost now found brings them breakfast in the morning and ice cold beer at night. She listens to them talk. She breaks up their fights. She stands her ground. Down the street, bottom line below us, about 10,000 feet, 22 below, you find a better place to go. You'd be here too, you know, you'd hang around. They just got married down in Arkansas. They lost a child and a job before he made the call. Heard the weather's rough and the houses few. You got something for me, sir? What's a man to do but try his round? Down the street,
you find a better place to go. You'd be here till you know you'd hang around. Boom chain. Boom chain. Oh, oh, stop by the farmhouse the other day. Jimmy's moved back home. He's helping Dad cut hay. Pumps in the morning, but he gets home by 5. We almost lost him there. Now he's more alive. God bless the sound.
Thank you. You're just a great audience. These are my kind of people. I could sit and visit with you all day. So come on backstage afterwards, and or wherever we're going to be, we'll sign some autographs and talk. Because if you learn anything in North Dakota with the Lutheran ladies, you learn how to visit. Right? So this is a wonderful place for me to be. I'm so happy to be here. So I got a love song for you. Ladies and gentlemen, I grew up, like I said, we raised horses and cattle, and when you raise cattle in the brush of western North Dakota on the edge of the Badlands, you need yourself a good dog, right? I know some of you have some great dogs. There's a lot of songs about man's best friend. I thought, you know, women are usually the ones that make sure those dogs are getting fed and walked. Maybe brushed every once in a while. So I thought, I'm gonna write a song about my dogs. When I moved back to the ranch 3 years ago, I didn't necessarily bring with me the epitome of cow dogs. However, I brought a 105-pound lab and a pug who had 2 eyes when we came to the ranch and now only has 1 after an unfortunate incident with a porcupine. He's all right, he just looks a little more tough, a little bit more like a pirate now. This is called A Girl Needs a Dog. Crumbs drop to your kitchen floor and then the tears, a little more. Days that seem to last too long, you reach for him. A girl needs a dog. Words unsaid to anyone. He warms your feet, you softly hum. Listening to your quiet songs. Big ears, big heart. A girl needs a dog. A girl needs a dog in times like these. Some hope and a plan, clarity. A girl needs a biker, her own car keys. A girl needs a dog. Hey, hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Hey, hey, yeah, yeah, yeah.
things that go bump in the night. Oh, slamming doors, a stupid fight. Someone who understands who's wrong. You climb in bed. A girl needs a dog. A girl needs a dog in times like these. Some hope and a plan. Clarity. A girl needs a bike or her own car keys. A girl needs a dog. A friend to always come along, no matter what. Girl needs a dog in times like these. Some hope and a plan, clarity. A girl needs a bike or her own car keys. A girl needs a dog.
Love song I've ever written. Some of you can relate, and I am ready to talk about your one-eyed dogs. So come and visit with me. See if I can get this on over my hair. You know, I usually play music with my dad. I grew up singing with him. He would be here with me tonight, but we almost lost him this month, and he's all right. I got a text from my little sister who said he was playing music in the bar. But I don't know. This man, my dad, is the reason that I have a love for play so strong that I have. He's a cowboy if there ever was one, and someone who really appreciates the beauty of a landscape and the idea that not everybody gets to sit on the top of a hill and look out over a place that their family has worked so hard to build and keep in their lives and in their family. And so to have us back, I have two sisters. All three of us are back in Western North Dakota, in town, and I'm on the ranch, and it sounds like my little sister is going to be out there too. And for my family and for my grandma and grandpa and for my grandpa's parents and my great-grandpa who settled the place, great-great-grandpa, we're happy to be here, carrying it on no matter how hard it is. Yeah. Thank you. But earlier this month, I got a call. We lived down the road from my dad and my mom. And it was at 2 a.m., and it's not one of those calls you want to get at 2 a.m., and my dad was on the other end of the line, and he said, Jessie, you got to come and get me. I'm not doing well. And we got him in an ambulance and got him to the hospital, and it turns out his heart was leaking into his body, and he had 1% chance to live, and he lived. Thank you. And he came out of that anesthesia in ICU, and he said, Jessie, I almost died. And I said, yes, I know, Dad, but you didn't. And he goes, you know why I didn't die, Jessie? I said, why? He said, because I'm a son of a bitch. My dad is not a son of a bitch, but he's a fighter. And so I sat down and wrote this song for him about 2 weeks ago. It's the first time I ever played it. This is called Northern Lights. And my dad plays the harmonica, so I'm going to try to play it. Forgive me if I skip that part. It's not easy to get lost among the wreckage here. They keep finding me and dragging my ass home. And behind
leave tracks, cause the snow keeps coming back. Even by myself, I'm not alone. And I'd like to be a man who stands for everything. Then I'd like to just sit quiet for a while. But I can't rest these legs, there's so much more to do today. Funny how a step becomes a mile. And it's cold as hell tonight, but you should see those northern lights dancing on the edge of frozen fields. If you need to leave, be gone, you need to stay. My God, hold on. I know this and northern lights have to be real. You should see those northern lights dancing on the edge of frozen fields. If you need to leave, be gone, you need to stay. My God, hold on. I know this and northern lights have to be real. Guess I'll live to be that old cowboy they said I'd be. Guess I'll find a few more winters up my sleeve. And these birds, they fly on wings, I fly on ordinary things, like your love and a reason to believe. And it's cold as hell tonight, but you should see those northern lights dancing on the edge of frozen fields. If you need to leave, be gone, you need to stay. My God, hold on. I know this and northern lights have to be real. If you need to leave, be gone, you need to stay. My God, hold on. I know this and northern lights have to be real.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. You all have a great evening. You're going to enjoy Martha and Brenn.
Jessie Veeder.
Thank you, Jessie. I'm just so impressed. I mean, how I know her and know where she lives and just her music and her words. And anyway, I'm just, gives me chills. I can't wait to see her the rest of the weekend as she performs at other venues. Next up, we have Brenn Hill. And for those of you who have been coming for many years, we've seen Brenn grow up. He first came in the 80s when he was 12 years old. He wasn't at the first, but he was at the second or the third. And it's just such a treat to host him on the stage tonight as part of this crew of the young musicians who are telling our stories and sharing the experiences of ranch families and cowboys far outside of where we live and where we work. What many people don't know is how generous Brenn is with his time and his resources. When I meet cowboy musicians and cowboy poets in Wyoming, they often reference the help that Brenn has given them in recording their work, in finding outlets for their performances, in connecting with them personally at different venues and festivals around the West. And I just so appreciate this gentleman and this young man and how he has really made it his calling to really support the community of musicians and poets that are out there and making sure that there's still a strong presence in our communities for this music and for this poetry. So please give a great Elko welcome to Brenn Hill.
Hey, well, what about Jessie Veeder? What do you think, huh? I never met her before this morning, but I said on the radio today, I'll say it again tonight. Just seeing her is worth the ticket, you know? My gosh. Cloud of dust down a gravel road, I headed straight for us by the home corral in the morning sun. Well, I'll be in love before the day is done, stepping down that rail in her tight blue jeans, a silver custom built hat by Chaz Mitchell and her well-worn jeans. She throws a gate out wide on a feather line, brings her own horse down and pulls the cinch up tight, and she can rope and ride a little better than me. She sure is a sight for a cowboy to see. She don't come down till the hard work's through. But take it from me, don't ask to see the buckaroo tattoo. She's a daddy's girl, she really don't care that he's an oil tycoon, multi-billionaire. 'Cause she'll be right on time when it's time to brand, when it's time to prove that a girl can make a good hand. She'd never give her heart to some rodeo wrangler or the college boys that keep trying to change her. 'Cause she's in love with her horse and her cow dog too. Take it from me, don't ask to see the buckaroo tattoo. I really don't know where, but it's gotta be there, round the back of her something, around the side of something else somewhere. Some say it's a rumor, I'm betting it's true. And take it from me, don't ask to see the buckaroo tattoo. You didn't hear it from me, don't ask to see the buckaroo tattoo. gather slack on a Saturday night on a horse bred Lucky J Pine. Spins his heels in the July dust and whispers everything's gonna be fine. The price of diesel's up $1.15 since they struck out in the spring. She broke left, they missed him clean. All she can do now is cling to the dream of a breakaway, runaway. There's another rodeo down a long dark road. She's far away from her Selway River home, but she's gonna bring the big money back one day. She's a breakaway, runaway. Her heart breaks at the sound of his voice saying, "Mommy, when you're coming back home?" She whispers soon, but she's got no choice. She never dreamed she could feel so alone. But there's a fire burning deep inside and a new hope shining in her eyes. She was born to rope and ride from the Texas plains to the Selway skies. She's a breakaway, runaway. Here's another rodeo down a long dark road. She's far away from her Selway River home. She's gonna bring the big money back one day. She's a breakaway, runaway. Mommy, when you're coming back home. Her heart's flying when the chute gate opens. Horses running like the Selway.
Thank you so much. I've been healthy all winter. I'm fighting a cold here this weekend. Got my spirits down more than anything, you know. Thought I had it licked. I got two songwriting heroes out here tonight. And one is a guy from Alberta by the name of Bruce Innes. Yeah. Some of you guys remember Bruce? One is a guy hails nowadays from Colorado by the name of Michael Martin Murphy. And so this is a song, I think, you know, I wonder sometimes, you write a song, you wonder if you got it right. This song, I was at a cowboy poetry gathering in Cedar City, Utah a number of years ago, and sat down to have some pie afterwards with an old Wyoming state trapper and court bailiff, and then a wonderful Western artist by the name of Jeff Wolf, who some of you are familiar with. And they sort of both looked at me at the same time. They said, "You got to write a song about Ed Cantrell." And I heard a little bit about Ed Cantrell when I was growing up. My dad spent a lot of time in Evanston and Rock Springs, and that was kind of where this legend derived from. And so old Ed Cantrell, I never got to play this song for him. When I started digging into his life, I was fascinated, still am. Love him or hate him, he was one heck of a lawman. National quick draw champion. Martial arts expert, stood all of about 5'5". Rabbits and the coyotes run. The red desert rolls on forever, blood red in the setting sun. The marijuana and the cocaine highway, federales couldn't keep it clean. State troopers start off the right way, but money was just a lawman's dream. And there's a whole lot of holes in Sweetwater County. One lone deputy upheld the law. He was a black belt in Kwando karate and a master of the old quick draw. We gave him hell. It came true. Took the long drive down to the Silver Dollar Bar. Take it slow, Sergeant Callis, you drive. There was a crooked smile in the rearview mirror, or he might have made it home alive. But as Rosa reached down for his ankle gun, Cantrell saw the flash through the thunderhead sky, and he was spitting lead before the crash. A 38 special right between the eyes. And there's a whole lot of holes in Sweetwater County. One lone deputy upheld the law. He was a black belt in Kwando karate and a master of the old quick draw. We gave him hell. It can't trail. Found Ed Cantrell not guilty. Some say he should have died in jail. He went back to Sweetwater County, ready to take on the whole cartel. The cattle rustlers and the low-dive dealers, they sweat bullets when they heard his name. Money and the drugs quit running. He was one for the lawman, a hall of fame. And there's a whole lot of holes in Sweetwater County. One lone deputy upheld the law. He was a black belt in Kwando karate and a master of the old quick draw. Give him hell. Ed Cantrell. So to all you criminals, you two-bit outlaws, drug runners and murdering thieves, you might go scot-free in this life. Better watch out when you leave. 'Cause if you're headed where the brimstone burns and boils, at the hot-black gaping jaws of hell, there's a five-star standing with a 38 pistol. It's gold badge deputy Ed Cantrell. And there's a whole lot of holes in Sweetwater County. One lone deputy upheld the law. He was a black belt in Kwando karate and a master of the old quick draw. They give him hell. Ed Cantrell. There's a whole lot of holes in Sweetwater County. Thank you so much. I had the pleasure of hosting a show today for two of the West's finest ever horsemen and probably the world's best cowboy balladeer. Some of you guys were at that show, maybe? Yeah. But, you know, I feel pretty transparent around Joel Nelson and Randy Reiman, I have to be honest with you. A lot of my songs that are about horses are written about lack of horsemanship. As this song, and also out of shame and guilt and a little bit of resentment, maybe, you know? But, you know, I was, I got my foot stepped on, and on a bright, sunny afternoon by the oldest, brokest horse on the place, and my wife came out. I was in denial, had tennis shoes on, was mowing the lawn, had to give her some medicine, and I didn't use a halter, and so my wife came out, and as I was limping around in denial, she said, come and get in the car. We're going to the emergency room to figure out what's wrong with your foot. And proceeded to call me numerous times the other side of the thing that stepped on my foot. So she's listening tonight, streaming live on the internet. Love her, love my family, and I'm still gimping on that foot. Ibuprofen takes the swell. Ice packs upon these old broken bones. Man, I still feel like hell. But I've had broken bones before. I've bucked off to save my life. This pain I feel, it will never heal. Your sharp tongue cuts me like a knife. Hell hath no fury like a cowgirl's goodbye. It's colder than the norther blowing across the Texas sky. Sharp like a dagger digging deep into my side. Hell hath no fury like a cowgirl's goodbye. I can't run to chase you down, and I won't make it on my own. Night comes again, the pain rushes in. I sober up and realize that you're gone. In hell hath no fury like a cowgirl's goodbye. It's colder than the norther blowing across the Texas sky. Sharp like a dagger digging deep into my side. Hell hath no fury like a cowgirl's goodbye. Be halfway to Oklahoma, just a whisper in the cold panhandle wind.
I'll be back on my feet in a couple of weeks, but I'll never be the same again. And hell hath no fury like a cowgirl's goodbye. It's colder than the norther blowing across the Texas sky. Sharp like a dagger digging deep into my side. Hell hath no fury like a cowgirl's goodbye. 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 Goodbye.
Oh, thank you so much. These girls back here are rough, you know. You play a little over your limit here, and it's... they're tough. I'm gonna close it out here. This has been Straddling the Line, so... they said we want you to play some sage rock. The original sage rock song about a guy who's had one job all his life, running the Bar B, the old Browning family spread just behind Huntsville, Utah, there up Gertsen Canyon, which is a big, steep, shaley, rattlesnake infested canyon. And old Bill Hadlock, known him pretty much all my life. And we rode out one day gathering some cows there, and he was on a beautiful bay colt. And I said, gosh, that's a beautiful bay colt you're riding there, Bill. He says, you know, he's coming along pretty good, but, you know, every once in a while he thinks there's a monster around every tree. And one of these days he's got to learn the monster's on his back. Thank you so much. God bless you guys for being here. I've rode this mountain 70 years, I've been alive. Choked on rocks and rattlesnakes, wonder I've survived. Don't think I haven't had a bronc like you, try me. Every time he thinks a monster is hiding around a tree, well, the monster's on your back, son. Better try to understand. The cowboy that you're fighting now is born in this here land. One day you'll learn your scars and all the fearlessness you lack. Don't worry about the things that you can't see. The monster's on your back. Now hear this, I've rode through howling hell, wind and snow and rain. I am oblivious to misery and pain. And that iron in your gizzard, it will never go away. So long as you got work to do today. And there's a monster on your back, son. Get your guts up off the trail. We got a job to do, and I promise we won't fail. One day you'll learn your scars and all the fearlessness you lack. Don't worry about that, Henri Charlebeau. The monster's on your back. You think that if you buck me off, I won't get back on. You could stomp me in the ground and I'd be gone. You think that this old man ain't tough like he wants.
once used to be. Try me one more time and you will see. There's a monster on your back, son. Better start to understand. The cowboy that you're fighting now was born to this here land. But one day you'll earn your scars and all the fearlessness you lack. Till then you're gonna have to trust in me. The monster's on your back. There's a monster.
Much. God bless. Happy 30th anniversary of Elko.
Brenn Hill.
Oh, this is such a great show. Thanks for being such a great audience. As we're straddling the line between this generation and the next, between the past 30 years and the next 30 years, we'll be welcoming on stage a true balladeer, a storyteller to her core. Martha Scanlan is from Tongue River in Montana, and her new album, Tongue River Stories, is available now. She's going to be sharing some of that work with you. By her side is John Neufeld, and between the two of them and their harmonies and the lyrics and the music that they play, you can tell that the land and the love of the land just oozes up through their toes and out their fingers and off their tongue. And it's really just a beautiful thing to hear. You're really going to appreciate the work of Martha and John.
I'm just joking, and you're a lovely and attentive audience, obviously. Sorry, it's considerably colder backstage than it is here.
I felt like the G was right, but I wasn't sure.
It'll totally be worth it. Leave me you. I have to say, I have had the nicest time tonight just listening to all this great music. Just what a cool night. And it's really cool to be part of this program with Brenn Hill and Jessie Veeder. Really great listening to their songs and just songs from different landscapes. It's kind of a snowy song.
Horses?
snow up high, snow on the mountains, snow on top of the trees. There's snow on the backs for grazing horses, snow falling on me. I live on a ranch in southeastern Montana off the Tongue River. John lives in the small ranching community of Portland, Oregon.
I wish I did.
Spends the day wrangling hipsters.
Oh, yeah. Recording Sorry. Studios and hipsters. Yep.
But his tie to this event is I wanted to do a recording of I was interested in recording songs in the places where they were written, and so I had musicians come out to this ranch and record, and we recorded, you know, a couple of songs in my cabin and a couple on my porch and a couple in this high meadow. It's one of my favorite places on the ranch, and it's where we wean calves in the fall and do a lot of work and a lot of riding up there. It's just this really long, beautiful meadow. So we recorded some songs up there. And so I had John come out and record. He's been there a couple of times. That was a fall recording, and we're working on a winter recording. The fall ones, a friend of mine who's fifth generation on one of those ranches nearby filmed. He's a filmmaker now in Bozeman named Dawson Dunning. And then John and I are working on a winter recording that we haven't filmed because so far we've done all of it in our pajamas.
It's the best way to record.
Anyway, so this is a song called The Meadow. Thank you.
where there is one star and the first bird sings.
I should say that one of the reasons I wanted to have John come out and do these recordings is that I knew he would be able to play the place and play that landscape and play everything and what all of that work and all of that sounds like. And I'm still kind of endlessly fascinated by that. This is a happier song if you just listen to the rhythm. If you listen to the words, the bar's still open.
My boots in the white old Missouri, send me on my way
Thank you. I'll do a little bird of heaven.
Sure. Not too far away to hug each other.
Yeah. So I'd like to say that I've been out in the cold feeding, but it's kind of a small operation. And so Terry does all the feeding with the tractor, and it's kind of impossible to help. I've helped before, and it's a very small space in that little cab in the tractor. And I work for an 83-year-old cowboy, and when I about 5 years ago, I went through kind of an intense breakup and was heading into the winter, and I could see it might be a challenging time. And I said, well, Irv, I was thinking maybe this winter I could work on my roping. And he's a really great roper. He was a champion steer roper. And he said, yeah, well, I've been thinking about getting a ping pong table. And he got his daughter to order one on Amazon. And they delivered it to Ashland, Montana, which is about 45 minutes away. And I went and picked it up at Fred's Hardware, the ping pong table. And he helped me load it into the back of a pickup truck. And I brought it back down. We set up in his living room. So when it gets cold,
ping pong.
The ping pong starts. It's not even funny, it's very serious. It's very competitive. And yeah, it's not easy to be constantly defeated by an 83-year-old cowboy, but he's very competitive and he's a very good ping pong player. So that has absolutely nothing to do with this song.
I'm ready to come out and challenge him.
Yeah, I double dare you. Come on
yeah.
out. Come on out, march.
Okay, I will.
This song called Little Bird of Heaven, nothing to do with ping pong. It's kind of almost happy.
Tell me it's a fragile thing. sing. It's hard to fly on broken wings. Lost my ticket to the promised land. Little bird heaven right here in your hand. So toss it up, pass it around. Pay mind on what you carry around. Keep it close, hold it while you can. Little bird heaven right here in your hand.
Again for having us and just being here and supporting this lovely thing. I'm going to play one more song and we'll be out in the lobby afterwards if you want to say hi and challenge me to a game of ping pong. It is always shocking to me to play for a bunch of people that generally have some idea of what I'm talking about with the little cab and the tractor. This is not always the case. Audiences around the country. Lots of polite smiles and blank stares. Anyways, thanks so much again. This is John Neufeld on the guitar.
Hello.
And,
Martha Scanlan.
Thanks again to Brenn Hill and Jessie Veeder and yeah, right? So cool. This song called The West Was Burning.
The year the west was burning, I was on a mountain sleeping. I woke up dreaming about you. I was walking down a road of dust and bones and ash, a pile of wind, a burning set of tracks that led to you. I still see the fire in your stare. I could have burned up there. Out the window there are fields of wheat and Kansas that roll on forever under, ever under, meet the sun. If I could lie there for a moment, I could feel your arms around me. I could feel the spinning round the spinning sun. A deep September turquoise sky. You and I. Thank you. inside a bottle doesn't seem to fill the empty cup inside your soul. And all the winding roads you used to follow never seem to get you half of where you know you think you need to go. Times of trouble, times of grace and ease. Mom always said there'd be days like these.
Wow. Whew. What a voice. What lyrics. What melody on a guitar, huh? It transports one beyond this room. I really appreciate that. I'd love to welcome all the artists back on stage for one more round of applause. Martha Scanlan, John Neufeld, Brenn Hill, Jessie Veeder. Come on out. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Here they are. The next 30 years of the gathering. I plan to see them here in 2044. Something to be proud of. We sure appreciate them. They're going to make their way over to the gift shop. There you can pick up an album. They'll be happy to autograph it. You can get their CDs. Be sure to take a piece of this concert home with you. It'll play for you the rest of the year and remind you to get tickets early to come back next year. So they're going to just make their way off. Give them a minute to get around. We'll just clap them off stage. Take a minute to get a couple of their CDs, and they'll be right there to autograph them. Also, join us after this over at the Western Folklife Center. I know that there's a lot of people hanging out, having a nightcap, a beverage of your choice.